Hello everyone, and welcome to this new minutes crash in which we will focus on the management of an execution plan. So we are in the campaign workspace, in the execution plan section of a test suite that I have chosen. So our execution plan is composed of a number of test cases with various attributes, and you can sort it by last execution date, for example, by user, and filter it by execution status, for example. So if we choose the status past, we only have here the status that have passed. It's possible to apply several filters to refine your selection. So here we will select the low importance, then to remove these filters and recover your complete execution plan again, we can simply click on result filters. You can make a filter for each column with the filter button, like here, 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 and specifically for the user filter. So it's presented as a list where the user can choose between the value unassigned and the list of users who have authorization on the project. So here the Squash administrator or the menu Squash. Each test case in the execution plan can be displayed by handling the left click on its number and moving it to the desired location. Like this. You can also assign the execution of tests to users from this execution plan section, no matter if you are in a campaign, an iteration, or a test suite. The button Modify the attributes allows the mass modification of attributes simultaneously. To do so, simply click on the instance number with a control click, like this. Then we click on the button and we will change the status to past, for example. In the execution plan of an iteration, click on Add a Test Suite button to create a new test suite into the execution plan. So here we will name it Evol3. Then you can add a test case to the execution plan by clicking the plus button and doing a drag and drop. Or we can also click on search for test cases and select test cases that we want. Click on associate the selection. Then you also have button to start the execution. This one. Finally, by clicking the link on the name of a test case, you can access to the test case consultation page. The link on the date of the last execution allows you to access the consultation page of the last execution. So that's it for this minute squash. We hope you enjoy it and see you soon for a new video.